So, you've probably heard the rumors about the reshoots for Captain America Brave New World after yet another negative test screening. Yep, this is the third test screening, and they're gearing up for their fourth round of reshoots. What's really going on with this project? What's happening? Marvel Studios? If you're starting to feel pessimistic about this movie, I have to admit, I'm right there with you. These reshoots are a pretty big red flag, hinting that something isn't working. And honestly, that's not a great sign for us fans who've been waiting for this movie for so long. In this video, we're going to dig into the situation and try to look at it from different perspectives. Sure, as fans, there's not much we can actually do, but knowing what's going on behind the scenes feels better than being left in the dark, right? Oh, and if you're new here, welcome! On this channel, we dive into everything MCU, superheroes, and the latest updates on movies and shows. If that sounds like your thing, make sure to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any exciting content coming your way. It's hard to ignore that all these reshoots for Captain America Brave New World are looking like a financial nightmare for Marvel Studios. Think about it. This is the fourth round of reshoots, and production costs have reportedly shot past $400 million. That's massive. For the movie to just break even, it'll need to make over $1 billion at the box office. And let's be honest, that's a really big ask. Why? Because in 2024, only two movies managed to hit that billion-dollar milestone. Inside Out 2, which made almost $1.7 billion, and Deadpool and Wolverine, just over $1.3 billion. Those films had incredible hype. Right now, it feels like Brave New World doesn't have anywhere near the same buzz. Even if Marvel and Disney can afford the costs, there's a bigger problem. Fans are starting to lose faith in this movie, and that's a huge issue. Here's the thing. News about these reshoots is coming out less than 3 months before the movie's release. That's cutting it really close, and it's a major red flag. Reports from insiders like Daniel RPK suggest there's chaos behind the scenes, which doesn't inspire much confidence. Fans are noticing, and they're not happy. Over the past few days, YouTube, Reddit, and Twitter have been buzzing with frustration. People aren't just upset about the reshoots, they're worried about what this says about the quality of the film. And honestly, who can blame them? What's making it worse is why these reshoots are happening. According to reports, the film got poor feedback during test screenings. Not just "it could be better" kind of feedback. People who saw it described it as inessential and flat. That's pretty harsh. This is a big deal because Captain America isn't just another superhero franchise. It's the legacy of Steve Rogers, one of the most beloved characters in the MCU. Fans were counting on Brave New World to be a worthy continuation of that legacy, especially with Sam Wilson stepping up as the new Cap. The stakes are high, but right now, it feels like the movie might fall short. And then there's the bad buzz. Negative word of mouth spreads fast, especially when it's coming from fans. If people start skipping the movie because they've heard it's not great, it's going to be even harder for Marvel to make back that massive budget. So yeah, things aren't looking good. For those of us who've been excited about Brave New World, this is starting to feel more and more like a disappointment waiting to happen. There's one thing that doesn't quite add up for me. Why is a massive studio like Marvel doing reshoots over and over for Captain America Brave New World just because of quality issues? Let's break this down. We've seen plenty of Marvel movies in the multiverse saga that got mixed reviews about their quality. Some were even considered flops, but those films still released on schedule and we didn't hear about reshoots on this scale. Post-COVID, lots of movies have struggled with quality, but they still moved forward. So why is Brave New World different? Here's the tricky part. Quality and fan reactions are always a gamble. Everyone knows that Sam Wilson, played by Anthony Mackie, hasn't fully clicked with audiences as the new Captain America. In fact, some fans openly disagree with Falcon taking on the mantle. But Marvel announced this movie way back at the 2022 San Diego Comic-Con, so they've had plenty of time to weigh the risks. They already tried establishing Sam as Cap in The Falcon and The Winter Soldier on Disney Plus. Now don't get me wrong, I'm not saying fans will automatically accept a movie with issues. What I am saying is that reshooting a film four times is not normal, even for Marvel. It's a massive move. From a financial perspective, these reshoots are a heavy burden. Maybe Captain and let's be real, they're not helping fan enthusiasm for the MCU, which is already shaky. But here we are with Anthony Mackie and even Giancarlo Esposito reportedly back on set for reshoots. That tells us Marvel is trying to fix something. But what? Is it really just about quality? Or could there be something else going on? Here's a theory. Could this be tied to the political themes of the movie? Think about it. Captain America Brave New World kicks off Marvel's 2025 slate, introducing Thaddeus' Thunderbolt Ross as the new US president, and eventually Red Hulk. This movie is set against a backdrop of politics. And let's not forget that we're in the middle of real-world political tensions in the US, especially post-election. Then there's Daredevil Born Again, which reportedly dives into local politics and corruption. And after that, we get Thunderbolts, which seems to follow similar political dynamics. It's almost like Marvel is doubling down on political storylines. I even made a whole video about this. Feel free to check it out on the channel if you haven't seen it yet. So here's my suspicion. What if the storyline in Brave New World is too risky politically? Maybe Marvel is worried about how it will be received. I hope I'm wrong, because if this is true, other projects like Daredevil and Thunderbolts could be in trouble too. And that's not a good place for the MCU to be. There's another possibility. In recent years, Marvel Studios has faced backlash over activist-driven storytelling in some of their films and series. Fans suspected these elements were dragging down the entertainment value. Marvel seems to have addressed this by letting go of certain creatives and refocusing on pure entertainment, which I think is a great move. But what if remnants of those earlier choices are still lingering in Brave New World? Maybe that's why they're doing reshoots, to clean up these elements, especially after poor test screening feedback. And here's my biggest fear. What if fans still aren't ready to accept Anthony Mackie as Captain America? Watching the trailer for Captain America: Brave New World a while back was honestly a joyful moment for me. Not because of Red Hulk, I'm not a huge fan of the whole smash and destroy thing, but because I saw something that stood out. Sam Wilson finally looked confident stepping into the role of Captain America. In that trailer, I felt like it was answering a big question that's been hanging over fans. Does Falcon deserve the title of Captain America? Based on what we saw, I think Anthony Mackie might just pull it off. Sure, not everyone will agree with me, but from those glimpses in the trailer, I didn't feel any hesitation about Sam Wilson taking up the shield and leading the MCU into its next chapter. That said, not everyone feels the same way. For a lot of fans, putting Sam Wilson in the Captain America role is a controversial move. Some argue it breaks the originality of the character. And yes, let's address the elephant in the room. Some of this criticism circles back to race. There's a belief among certain fans that Captain America should remain a white character to preserve his original identity. This is where Bucky Barnes comes into the picture. Many fans feel that if anyone should inherit the Captain America mantle, it's Bucky. After all, he was Steve Rogers' best friend since World War II, someone who truly understood him. Bucky shares Steve's values, his history, and even his worldview. To these fans, Sebastian Stan's Bucky feels like the natural choice, an extension of Steve's legacy that keeps the spirit of Captain America alive. And honestly, I get it. If Marvel had chosen Bucky to take the shield, a lot of these debates might not even exist. The move would feel seamless for many, tying directly back to Steve Rogers' story. But here's the catch. Handing the shield to Bucky wouldn't be as simple or straightforward as it sounds. And it might not even be the right move. The MCU already set its course with Steve Rogers' story arc in Avengers Endgame. That arc ended with Steve passing the shield to Sam, solidifying his choice. The Falcon and the Winter Soldier doubled down on that decision, showing us Sam's struggle and eventual acceptance of the mantle. For Marvel to backtrack now and give the title to Bucky wouldn't just feel inconsistent, it would undermine everything they've built since Endgame. This is about more than just continuity. It's about honoring Steve Rogers' legacy while letting the MCU grow and evolve. Steve's Captain America defined the MCU for over a decade, but the story has to move forward, and Marvel is clearly committed to making Sam Wilson's journey as Captain America a meaningful part of that evolution. It's hard not to feel a little disappointed hearing this news. After getting our hopes up with the trailer, now we're faced with reports of reshoots that clearly point to issues with Captain America: Brave New World. Maybe the planning for this movie was flawed from the start. Whether it's the story ideas, the character choices, or even a script that struggles to meet everyone's expectations. Still, I'm holding on to hope that this movie can come together in the end. I really hope Marvel Studios takes a safer and more careful approach. Budget concerns are their responsibility, but at the end of the day, fans deserve to walk out of the theater feeling entertained. If the movie isn't fully polished by its scheduled release in February 2025, I honestly wouldn't mind if they delayed it again. Delaying the release isn't just about buying more time. It's about protecting the potential of characters like Sam Wilson, Red Hulk, and others who could shine brighter in future MCU projects. The last thing we want is for Brave New World to mishandle these characters and leave fans uninterested in what comes next. That's my take. What about you? Are you still excited for Captain America: Brave New World? How do you feel about all these reshoots? Let me know in the comments. Before we wrap up, if you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel. Your support means the world to us and helps us keep bringing you high quality content. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and share it with your friends so we can keep the discussion going. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.